Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. Today is the day when we'll publish our package. First of all, we'll test by installing it from our local machine, and then afterwards we'll publish it to the Packagist. First of all, let us try to install it via Composer. So I'll say Composer require /password change notification. And now here it will show an error because it is not actually added to the Packagist. And we already have this package in our local machine. Here I have already opened this package project as well. Now I'll go here in my Laravel project, and in order to test it from the local machine, we have to do it in this way. So here I'll say repositories. It will contain an array of objects, and here we'll say type will be path, and it will also contain the URL key, and this URL will contain the full path of the project. So here in the password change notification package, I'll go here and I'll say pwd. It will give me the current working directory of the project. I'll copy it from here and I'll paste it here in my Laravel project like this. After adding this, I'll be able to add it via the Composer. So whenever I run Composer require, then it will look into this directory and it will find this package and it will install it from this directory. So here I'll say, and I'll install the dev version of it for now and hit enter. So you can see that it has installed the package, and whenever it installs this package, it will link to this project directory, and whatever changes that we make over here in this package, it will automatically get reflected in our Laravel project codebase as well. Now let's see how to use it. So let me go to the user model, and here I'll say implements password changed notification contract, and it is automatically imported over here. And here we'll use password changed notification thread. So this is all that we need to do. By default, the package will consider there is an email column and the password column, which I have in my case the users table. So now I don't have to do anything, it will just work. So let me show you that. So here in the tinker, I'll find a user, and here I'll change the password, let's say PSSW, and here I'll save the user. And just before saving, let me show you here in the mail tab, I don't have any emails. And now if I hit enter, it has sent the mail. It took a little while because it is not added to the queue. And now here in the mail tab, we can see the email. Now let's say you have a different column name for the email address, then you can just easily go inside this thread and copy this method, come here in the users model and just paste this method over here, and just let's say you have a user underscore email as the email column name, then you can just return it and it will take email value from this column. But I don't need to do this. Now let's say I want to add this email to the queue, then I'll again go to this, and everything that I am doing here will be added to the readme file and will be available as a documentation in the GitHub repo. So here I'll just copy this and paste it over here, and instead of false I'll say true. And again I'll open the Tinkerwell, find the user, change the password, and save the user. You can see here it is saved so quickly, and here in the browser we don't see any mail because it is added to the queue. And now we need to run the queue like this. It is processing, and now the mail has been processed, and here we can see the same mail. Okay, now let me remove this. Now let's say you don't want this message to be sent to the user, you want a different mail. So for that, just go here and say PHP artisan vendor publish and dash tag password changed notification views and hit enter. Now it will publish the mail view that will be sent to the user, and it will be added to this resources views vendor folder. And inside the vendor folder we'll have this password changed notification folder emails, and here we have password changed notification blade. Now we want to change the customized mail. Now again I'll just open the Tinker, find the user, change the password, and save. And in the browser we'll see the customized mail. But again, let's say you don't want to use this password change notification blade view. You want to create your own mailable. Then also you can do php artisan make mail, and let's say new password change notification mail, and the markdown will be this. And if I hit enter, then it will create this app mail, and here it is returning this new password change notification markdown blade file. And I'll say here the new mail via mailable. Now to use this mailable, we have to go again here in the user model, and let me see the method name inside the straight, which is this. Now here in the users model, I can just paste it. Let me import this mailable, and here instead of password change notification mail, we'll say new password changed notification mail, and these things are imported over here. Okay, we have returned this from here, and now again let me open the Tinkerwell, find the users, change the password, and again save it. And in the browser we'll see that the new mail via mailable, so it is very customizable. Now we have checked it in our local machine, it's time to publish it to the Packagist. I have already opened the GitHub repo of the package and this Packagist. So here I'll go to settings, and then it was private before, I need to make it public. So I'll say here change visibility, and please type this, it is saying me, so I'll just copy and paste it and change it to make public, and then I'll say I understand and change the repository visibility. Now the repository is changed to public. Then we'll go here in the packagist.org. I'll leave the link of this Packagist website just below that like button. And here you need to register first. Then go to the submit, and it will ask us the repository URL. So here, just before the settings part, I'll copy and add it over here like this. And check. And it says the package name found for your repository is this one, and it took from the composer.json file, and yes, this is the name that I want. If you want a different name, then you can change it in the composer.json file. Now I'll submit it. Now the package had been submitted to the composer, and again people will not be able to install this package because we haven't tagged it. So let me go to the package repository in my GitHub. So this is the one. And these are the list of all the commits that I have done, and I'm using this Git graph extension to view it. Now let me tag it. So here I'll say add tag, and I'll say 1.0.0 for now. And I also want to push it to the remote. Now I'll say add tag, and it will automatically push it to the GitHub as well. So after I have done tagging, then I can go here in the GitHub, and let me go to this password changed notification. And let me see here inside the tag, then I can see this 1.0.0 tag. After I have tagged it, I'll go here and again click on update. The package has been successfully updated, and now it will take a little bit while for this package to be available in the composer, and then we'll be able to install it in our Laravel project using composer. So now let me go to our Laravel project, and I'll just commit it. So here, and I'll add the commit as test the package locally. So now let me remove this package as well first, and then we'll install it via the Packagist. The package is removed, and now if you look here in the composer.json file, we don't see that package. And here in the user model, we still have these things implemented, but now here if I just go here in the Tinker, and then I'll just find the user, then you can see here interface this not found. Since we have uninstalled the package, it is not found, but after we install it via composer, it will install it from the Packagist server itself. So let us try it. And now we don't have to write here at the rate dev. So we'll say composer require and hit enter. You can see here it is now successfully installed from the live Packagist server. Now here let me open the Tinker and again let me find a user and let me change the password, and again let me save the user. Then it will again send the mail, and you can see this new mail via mailable because we have done the modifications before in the model. Here we are returning this thing, so we are getting this message from here. So I hope you enjoyed this series, and if I have missed something then just let me know in the comment section below, because there is always something new to learn. You learn from me and I learn from you, so please share something that you know. So that's it for this video guys. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.